A House Science, Space, and Technology Subcommittee on Research and Technology holding a hearing Tuesday morning focused on new and developing biotechnologies enabled by engineering biology research and their potential applications in sustainable agriculture. Hang on, follow me for just a moment. Dr. Rob Carlson is Managing Director of Bioeconomy Capital and explained that biosecurity is now clearly synonymous with economic security, and the focus of policy must shift from protecting specific targets from specific threats to securing the bioeconomy as a system that drives economic growth and employment, and ultimately enables humans to thrive on a global scale. The idea of animal antibiotic resistance is one area that those who testified thought biotechnology could fix. Well, agricultural researchers generate vast amounts of data, yet little of that is shared and among the peers and accessible to those in the public. But there is a group of scientists this week calling on others for change, proposing that the infrastructure to make it happen be built. They say solving the world's grand challenges, like feeding nearly 10 billion people by the year 2050, reducing greenhouse gas emissions, and ensuring access to clean water worldwide, really depends heavily upon ag research and advances. Individual studies chip away at the issues, but if we could actually combine the data from multiple efforts, it would offer opportunities to reduce global change. Currently, there is a lack of standardized methods for organizing ag data, and it makes it difficult to combine the data into one big study. So scientific journals have some of it, but they put it behind paywalls. That could keep the public and other researchers who can't afford the access from accessing that information. So at this point, they're calling on all institutions to bridge the gaps between ag researchers and data scientists, hoping to build some type of a platform soon. And finally, Environmental Protection Agency announcing a proposed regulatory change that will allow gasoline blended with up to 15% ethanol, we call this E15, to be sold year-round. Now, on Tuesday, the EPA Administrator Andrew Wheeler explained that in addition to the expansion of E15 sales year-round, the agency also proposing to modify elements of the Renewable Identification Numbers, or REN, that system under the Renewable Fuel Standard Program. He wants to enhance transparency in the market while deterring price manipulation. Says EPA will welcome public comment on the proposal, intends to hold a public hearing at the end of the month. And with another Ag News Update, I'm Tony St. James.